Developmental disabilities have not held a talented group of Columbus area artists back, and in Lancaster, we'll give you their inspiring story next.
And later this.
The aim of art is to represent not the outward appearance of things, but their inward significance. Those are the words of ancient Greek philosopher Aristotle, but they have never been more relevant than they are at a downtown Lancaster art gallery, where inward significance is expressed by some special artists, and their studio's founder and staff are paying it forward with brushstrokes of inspiration.
Little tiny ones.
Oh, see? You want little sweeps.
Little ones, yeah, just the little sweeps like you do.
Okay.
And I actually had just a real divine call to take what he had given me as talents, mm-hmm. and to take that, and instead of doing it myself, which I had enjoyed for 20 years, mm-hmm. that instead I should help marginalized persons discover their God-given talents.
Cheryl tells me she heard that call 7.5 years ago. The former Walnut Ridge chemistry teacher and 20-year touring muralist won the support of the Fairfield County Board of Developmental Disabilities and launched Blue Shoes Art Studio in the Fairfield Adult Services Facility. It was named after initial artist Joe Green's signature blue shoes that he used in all his paintings.
That's going to be a good one, Joe.
Joe's still a member, but these days he has a lot of company.
Oh my gosh, this is so detailed. I love it.
From Rachel's ink to Stephanie's acrylic still life, the numbers of artists have grown to 15 or more, but they've had no place to display their art until a downtown gallery headed for closure 1.5 years ago got new life, purchased by the County Board of Developmental Disabilities.
And if we allowed essentially the Jewel on Main Street in Lancaster, Art and Clay on Main, to close, people would go, there goes another local business.
Mm-hmm.
And downtown suffers just a little bit more. It was our opportunity to give back and say, not only are we going to contribute to the vibrancy of the community, but we're going to involve folks with disabilities to do that.
The spectrum of disability is large. Jesse Bash has dealt with minor delays, slight cerebral palsy, and was socially and verbally introverted. But I'm told through Blue Shoes, she's flourished.
It's meant a lot to me, getting my business started with my art and working here and be able to teach classes.
Does that make you feel good about yourself?
Yeah.
And here, the Blue Shoes art is sold right next to works by artists without developmental disability.
People with talent, and that's the inclusion part. We work very hard here to promote the concept of inclusion, that people with and without disabilities are working, creating, and enjoying together and side by side.
Cheryl says she's been called to pay it forward at a senior facility near Pickerington, but tells me she'll visit her friends often, confident that Art and Clay on Main will always be a place where beauty's celebrated and the whole community is honored.
Thank you, Cabot, for sharing that very important work. And we are here in...